Now we will solve the magic square puzzles. First, I'll tell you the basic of the magic squares. Okay, this is a 8x8 grid, and certain numbers are in the visible, like 38, 12, 57, and 23. They are in the visible mode, and each one, this is a cell. This is a cell. The sum of these two cells is given here. This is 50. The sum of these two cells is given here. It is 78, like that. And as we saw earlier, this magic square, 8 numbers give you 260 in row, column, and diagonal. And each 4x4 is a magic square, and they give you 130 row, column, diagonal. Okay. Now we are going to use those rules. And again, as I said to you earlier, in my magic square puzzle, it is a speciality that these 2x2, these 2x2, these 2x2, these 2x2, they also give you magic sum of 130. And center 2x2 always gives you the magic sum 130. Okay, keeping these things in mind, we have to solve this magic square puzzle. Okay, now suppose if I am going to solve this one, okay, what does it mean? We have got one number in open, visible, 57. This is 25. These two numbers add up to 25. Third number is 57. What is the fourth number? Fourth number is 130 minus 25 plus 57 is 82. Okay, 130 minus 82, 48. Okay. These two cells add up to 56. We have found out one cell, one number in one cell, that is 48. The other number is 8. Okay. Now we will solve, find out what is this value of this square. These two numbers add up to 105. We know the third number, it is given 23. And what is this number? This is 105 plus 23 is 128. Okay. This is 2. You see, in my magic square puzzle, you can start anywhere, go anywhere, again come anywhere. So, see, this number we can find out. These two cells are up to 25, and these three cells are up to 161. And what is this number? You can find out. We again know this 2x2 gives you magic sum 130. What is the addition of these five cells? 25 plus 161 is 186. And these four numbers gives you 130. 186 minus 130, it is 56. This here, the number 38 is given in visible mode, and these two numbers are up to 33. So what is this 38 plus 33? 41, 71. So 130 minus 71 is equal to 59. Now we will solve this one, this number. Here we can use one formula. As I said to you earlier, in a magic square puzzle, this 2x2 and this 2x2 gives you magic sum of 130. Any this shaded regions gives you 130. Okay. Now we see 57 plus 48 plus 8. That comes to 56 plus 57, 113. So 130 minus 113 is 17. These two numbers gives you 33. One we have found out as 17. Another one is 16. 33 minus 17, 16. These two cells add up to 99. One of the cell has got a value of 59. The other one is 99 minus 59 is 40. This cell we can find out like using the formula. This plus this plus this plus this gives you 130. Okay, so 57 plus 16 plus 56, it gives you 129. So here you get the value 130, because the magic sum is 130, and these four numbers add up to give you 130, and these three numbers add up to give you 129, therefore it is 1. Now we can find out this number. These two cells add up to 25. One of the numbers we have found out, that is 1, another one is 24, because 1 plus 24 is equal to 25. Again we can see these four numbers, we can solve it either this way, or these four numbers added together, it gives you value of 130. So 1 plus 57 plus 48 is equal to 106. 106 minus 130 minus 106 is 24. That way also we can calculate. Now we will solve this one. These two cells add up to 42, and this cell we have found out it is 24. That is 42 plus 24 is equal to 66. And we know any column or row it should be 130. So this one is 130 minus 66. It is 64. Now we can find out this one. As we saw earlier, this is a cage. Okay. Each one is a cell, and this is a cage, and this cage consists of three cells, and these three cells add up to 161. So what is these two number add up to? That is 64 plus 56 is equal to 120, and 161 minus 120 is 41. We can also find this number another method. These four numbers should add up to 130.
1 plus 24 is equal to 25. 25 plus 64 is equal to 89. 130 minus 89 is 41.
Again, these four numbers, we can also solve this number using this formula also. These four numbers should add up to 130. So these three numbers we have found out. 64 plus 17 plus 8, they give you a total of 89. And so 130 minus 89 is equal to 41. We will solve this square. Here, there is one rule. Center 2 by 2 gives you a magic sum. That rule is there. So 64 plus 33. These two add up to 33. 64 plus 33 is equal to 97. 130 minus 97, 33. So this number we can again find out. See, these four numbers should add up to 130. We have found out three numbers. 56 plus 33 plus 16 is equal to 89, 89, 95, 105. Here you get answer 25. 130 minus 105 is 25. That's why we have found out. We will solve this one. We know that these two cells add up to 80. What is this cell? 80 minus 25 is equal to 55. Now we will solve this square. This square can be solved in many methods. So this column should give you 130. And it gives you 1 plus 41, 42. 42 plus 56 is equal to 98. 130 minus 98 is 32. Okay. We can either solve it this way, or diagonal should give you 130. That also we can use it. Or 8 plus 25 is equal to 1 plus 32. That formula also we can use it. 8 plus 25 is 33. 1 plus 32 is 33. Now we will solve this square. These three cells add up to 81. So 48 plus 8 plus 25 is 81, and 130 minus 81 is 49. Now we will solve this square. Okay, this we can solve in many different ways. Simple method is these two cells add up to 42. One of the cell we have found out 33. Another one is 42 minus 33. It is 9. Or we can also add up these four squares to give you 130. That method also we can use, or we can use to apply the formula. 1 plus 48 is equal to 9 plus 40. That formula also we can use. Now we can solve this square. These two cells add up to 35. And one of the squares we have found out, it is 32. The other one is 35 minus 32 is 3. Now we will solve this square. One number it is given in the visible mode, 23. And these two numbers add up to 97. So these three numbers add up to 23 plus 97 is 120, and we know that this column should add up to 130. 130 minus 120, this is 10. Okay. Now we will solve this square. These two cells add up to total of 31, and one of the cells we have found out is 10. Another one is 31 minus 10, that is 21. This number we will now find out. We know these two cells are up to 105, and these three cells are up to 51. But these four cells should add up to 130. So what is this cell? 105 plus 51, that is equal to 156. These five are up to 156, but we know these four cells should add up to 130. So this is 156 minus 130, 26. Now we will solve this square. We know that these two cells add up to 54, and these cells add up to 26. We also know that these four cells should add up to 130. What is this cell? 54 plus 26 is 60, 80. 130 minus 80 is 50. Now we will solve this square. These two cells add up to 95. One of the cells we have found out, it is 50. Another one is 95 minus 50, that is equal to 45. Now we will solve this square. Again, we can use the same formula. Here you see these five squares add up to 89 plus 46. That is equal to 95, 135. Okay. So 89 plus 46 is 95. 135. These 5 cells add up to 135, but we know that these 4 cells should add up to 130. So what is the 5th cell? 135 minus 130, and this is 5. Again, we can solve this number. We can solve it two way. These 5 numbers add up to 132 plus 41, 173. But we know that these 4 numbers add up to 130. 173 minus 130 is 43. We can solve that way also. Again, we know that these 4 numbers add up to 130, and this is 3, and these 2 adds up to 84. These 3 add up to 87. So 130 minus 87 is 43. Now we will solve this square. You see, these 2 cells add up to 41. This is an open cell. This cell is given in visible mode. This is 38. 41 plus 38 is equal to 79. We know that this 4 cell should add up to 130. 130 minus 79 is equal to 51. Now we know that these 2 cells add up to 78. One of the numbers we have found out to be 51. What is the other one? 78 minus 51. That is 27. Now we can find out this number. We know that these 3 numbers, these 2 numbers add up to 78, and this number is 38. 78 plus 38, 86, 96, 106, 116. So 130 minus 116 is 14. And we now solve this one. Okay, these 2 squares add up to 33. One we have found out to be 14. What is the other one? 33 minus 14, that is 24, and it is 19. Now we will solve this square. Okay, we are going to use this formula. These 4 cells should add up to 130. That is one of the rules of magic square, isn't it? So 43 plus 19 plus 38 is equal to 100. This is 130 minus 100, that is 30. Now we can find out this square. Okay, we know these 4 numbers should add up to 130. What is these 3 numbers we have found out? 3 plus 43, 46. 46 plus 30 is 76. 130 minus 76 is 54. Now we will solve this square. We will be using formula. 3 plus 30 is equal to 27 plus x. Okay. This plus this should equal to this plus this. 3 plus 30, 33. And 27 plus 6 is 33. So therefore, here the answer is 6. Now we will solve this square. Okay, we know that this column should add up to 130, and these 3 cells add up to 78 plus 6, that adds up to 84, and 130 minus 84 is 46. Now we will solve this one. We can solve this. You see, these 4 numbers should add up to 130. 43 plus 19 plus 6 add up to 62, 68, this adds up to 130 minus 68 is equal to 62. Now we will solve this square. Okay, we know this can be solved in many ways. These 3 numbers should add up to 132. That rule also you can use, or you can use the center 2 by 2 should always give you magic sum. We will see this one. 43 plus 54 is equal to 97, and 132 minus 97 is 35. We can solve this number. This you can solve in many different ways. Either these 4 numbers should add up to 130, that formula you can use. These 4 numbers should add up to 130, that formula you can use. Or simply, these 2 numbers should add up to 84. That formula you can use. See, 84 minus 62 is equal to 22. Now we will solve this square, this cell. This could be found in many different ways. You can use this formula. 3 plus 46 is equal to x plus 38. That formula you can use. Or these 4 numbers should add up to 130, that formula I can use. Or these 4 numbers add up to 130, that formula I can use. You can use any different way. Or simply, these 2 numbers add up to 41. One we have found out 30, another one is 11. Now we will solve this square, okay? These 2 cells add up to 50. One of the cell number is 6, other one is 44. Now we will solve this number, this square. You see, these 2 numbers we know add up to 82, and this number adds up to 44. 82 plus 44 is equal to 126. 130 minus 126 is 4. Now we can solve this square. We know that these 4 numbers should add up to 130. what is these three numbers add up to? 49 plus 46 is equal to 95. 95 plus 4, 99, and 130 minus 99 is 31.
Generally, this 2 by 2, that is the center 2 by 2 of 8 by 8, doesn't give the magic sum. In this magic square, it happens to give the magic sum.
Now we will solve this number. We know that these four numbers should add up to 130. Okay, what is this number? 31 plus 10, 41. 41 plus 50, 91. 130 minus 91 is equal to 39. Now we will solve this square. These two cells add up to 54, that we know. That method also you can find out. But these four cells add up to 130, that also you can find out. But simply we will use these two cells add up to 54. One cell we have found out to be 39. What is the other one? So that is equal to 15. 39 plus 15 is equal to 54. These three numbers, these four numbers should add up to 130. These three numbers add up to 96. Okay. 130 minus 96 is equal to 34. Now we will find out this number. We have found, that's the formula like this. This plus this plus this plus this gives you 130. 55 plus 2, 57. 57 plus 15. Is equal to 62, 72. 130 minus 72 is 58. Now we will find out this number. We know that these two cells add up to 105. One we have found out to be 50. What is the other one? That is equal to 105 minus 58. That is 47. Now we will find out this square. These two cells add up to 44. One we know to be 2. What is the other one? 44 minus 2, that is equal to 42. Now we will find out this square. We know these two cells add up to 97 and this cell adds up to 15. 97 plus 15 is equal to 102, 112. So this number is 130 minus 112, that is 18. Now we solve this one. We know these two cells add up to 97, one of the cell is 34. What is the other one? So that is 97 minus 34, that is equal to 63. 63. Now we will find out this square. This you can find out many different ways. These four numbers add up to 130. That formula you can use. These four numbers add up to 130. That formula you can use. Or this plus this is equal to this plus this. That formula you can use. Okay, we will use this formula. 2 plus 31 is 33 and 26 plus x is 33. What is this 26 plus x? This is 7. 26 plus 7 is 33. So 2 plus 31 is 33. 7 plus 26, 33. Okay, now we will find out this number. Okay, these four numbers should add up to 130. That is a rule. Okay, now what is these three numbers add up to? 4 plus 21, 25. 25 plus 45, 70. 130 minus 70, this is 60. Okay, and now we know that these two cells add up to 80. What is this number adds up to? 60, 80 minus 60. 20. That way you can find out 80 minus 60 is equal to 20. Okay. Now we can find out this one. We know the center 2 by 2 always gives you magic sum. These two cells add up to 97 and this cell adds up to 20. 97 plus 20 is equal to 117. 113 minus 117 is 13. Okay. And now we can see these three cells add up to 46, but these two cells add up to 18. What is that third number? That is 46 minus 18, that is equal to 28. Okay, now we can solve this number also. We know these four numbers add up to 130. Okay, now 45 plus 5 50, 50 plus 28 is 78. This is 130 minus 78. This is 52. Okay. Now we will solve this number. Okay. You can use the formula. This plus this is equal to this plus this. Okay. Now 45 plus 52 is 97. 97 minus 44 is equal to 53. Okay. So now we will solve this number. Okay. We are going to use this formula. This plus this is equal to this plus this. What is this? 4 plus 52 is 56. This plus this should be equal to 56. One number we know, 20. And what is this? 36. 56 minus 20, it is 36. Okay. And now this number you can find out straightly, simple method, that 97 minus 36, that is equal to 61. That you can find out. Now we will solve this number. We will using the formula 4 plus 45 is equal to 12 plus x. That formula we will be using. This plus this is equal to this plus this. 4 plus 45 is 49. 12 plus 37 is also equal to 49. Okay. And now we are left with only one number in the square. These two cells add up to 82. One of the numbers we have found out. What is this number? 82 minus 53 is equal to 29. This you can use to do it like this. So like this straight method, or diagonals give you 130, or this plus this is equal to this plus this. That formula you can use, or these four numbers add up to 130. That formula you can use. You can use anyway. Now we have completed one magic square puzzle. Okay, there are a lot of puzzles like that available on the website. Anybody can go and play the game. And while you start doing the students, I conducted this magic square puzzles in many schools, and wherever I have conducted, I have seen the response of the students to be unbelievable. They show tremendous interest in this puzzle, and they vie with one another. They come to the podium and to solve this puzzle. And even if the students they are poor in mathematics, or those who fear mathematics, what they start first when they start doing it, even if they start doing it with calculators, slowly and steadily they gain proficiency and start doing it in their mind itself.
You said that there's a lot of welcome from the student side for this kind of a magic square puzzle.
Yeah.
But what is the benefit for the students by playing this game?
You see, nowadays students, they do most of the arithmetic work using calculators only. And they don't do mathematics, even for simple arithmetic operations, they don't use the mind. They use only the calculators. But solving this puzzle game involves lot of addition and subtraction. Maybe to solve one puzzle game, they have to even use hundreds of calculations. They have to do at least hundreds of calculations, like addition and subtraction. When they start doing it, even if the children are not proficient in mathematics, even if they fear mathematics, even if they start doing using calculators, slowly and steadily they come out of the habit of using calculators and start doing addition and subtraction in their mind. I won't say this will happen overnight. It will happen in a natural process. Even if they don't use the mind to solve all the problems, what they will do is the dependence on calculators will come down drastically. That is the benefit for the children. And again, once the fear factor is removed from the mathematics, arithmetic, then what happens is that they will love the subject. They love mathematics. That they become more confident in the subject.